I went to the garden, but you didn't come.
What are you telling me, young man?
You said to me that you were going to tell me about your suspicions in the garden.
Oh? I couldn't have. I don't remember. Suspicions of what?
Relating to the deaths of Gottfried and Umberto.
Oh my God. Have they died? What a tragedy. In that case, I'll stay right here and pray for them.
I really think you ought to come and meet me. If the garden doesn't seem discreet enough for you, I'll see you in my cell.
What? Oh, yes, yes, but don't let yourself be confused by the demon. This abbey is full of demons, and they hear everything we say.
Precisely, Brother Arcadio. Precisely my point. I'm off again, Martin. I see you finally come.
Yes? I have to protect myself in this cell, don't I? Didn't you know? There's a murderer in the abbey, and he wants to kill me to get his hands on my treasure.
Ah, I see.
Yes, but he wouldn't dare come in here. I'm safe here. Leave me alone. Out! Get out!
Bruno, we're going out for a moment. And leave Brother Arcadio here alone with his lunacy.
What's going on, Master?
It's obvious that Brother Arcadio is keeping something from us. On the other hand, he might also want to tell us something. We'll see. Bruno, stay near the doorway. It would be better.
Yes, Master.
You've finally come by yourself, Leonardo. I'm glad that you've understood how to interpret my signals correctly.
They were much too clear for a senile mind, that's certain. Though I must admit, you've had me confused ever since we met.
I regret that I couldn't be frank with you this afternoon, but I have to be very careful.
Rest easy, brother. No one is going to interrupt us, and I give you my word that nothing you say to me will ever leave these four walls. For my part, it's as if I were hearing confession.
You won't tell your novice either?
I promise not to.
That's good enough for me. You're a righteous, noble man, and you deserve my complete trust. I'm aware that you had problems at court that led to the confrontation with Nazario.
Yes. I'm not looked on particularly well by the Emperor's advisors.
Which is precisely why Nazario's arrival fundamentally changed the situation at the Abbey. I must tell you everything I know.
Please do. Go right ahead.
Perhaps you think it's my destiny at this monastery to be a simple gardener. Then it will certainly come as a surprise to you that I...
You were supposed to be the abbot.
I was supposed to be the abbot. Hey, what? You knew?
In light of the relationship between the abbot and Segundo, it's not hard to imagine that, as is common practice at many abbeys, whoever holds the post of prior is going to be appointed abbot someday. I overheard a remark from Nicholas that you were once prior here, so the question arises... How did the current abbot obtain his position?
You're intelligent. You wouldn't be surprised if the person you trusted most betrayed you. But I didn't see it coming back then.
The abbot betrayed you?
Andres, that's his name. Although Judas would be more fitting, was my novice. I was responsible for his training and for having him enter this abbey. He's not a bad person at heart, but he comes from a very rich aristocratic family and always placed too much weight on appearances. Can you imagine having a novice like that?
I think I can vividly imagine what it's like.
His father was very close with the Emperor. So even though the appointments come from the Cardinal, it seems as if the Emperor himself had an interest in appointing him abbot. He, of course, wasn't content with that. No, he had to top it off by having me do a gardener's work.
But you didn't simply resign yourself to that, did you?
I couldn't fathom the whole situation. What interest could the Empire have in something like that? But shortly afterwards, new copyists arrived, young monks from many different countries. It was obvious that everything that was going on revolved around the library. So, I started looking into things here and there.
You didn't sneak into the library, did you?
No, that's impossible. Only the librarian has free access. But I was able to get a look at Andreas' office without being seen. I was trying to find proof that his election to the post as abbot wasn't proper. That dark interests were involved. Something that would incriminate him and taint his aura of sanctity.
Something that would have permitted you to take on the position as abbot.
It wasn't a question of my ambition. It had to do with seeing justice done. There are many dark secrets at this abbey. Too many that must be unveiled.
That's ironic commentary coming from someone who masks his true self daily, isn't it?
You'll see. The abbot had several books on his desk that hadn't gone up to the library yet. They were strange books. They were...
Heretical books? Satanic?
Could be. Two of them were written in foreign languages, and the third one in perfect Latin, by the way. Dealt with witchcraft.
But a book like that... in the hands of the copyists at a library.
Despite the care that is always taken at this abbey when working with parchment, don't let appearances deceive you one bit. Apart from the 5 or 6 monks who are fairly well educated, most of the members of this community can't read. First and foremost among them, the copyists.
Yes, I've visited quite a few libraries in the course of my travels where the monks didn't understand a word they copied. They merely tried hard to reproduce the shapes as best they could. But at an abbey like this...
Especially at one like this.
But I still can't explain to myself why you've been pretending to everyone that you've lost your mind.
They caught me red-handed. The abbot... Marcello and Secundo came in at just the wrong moment. Someone said, "Brother Arcadio, have you lost your mind?" It occurred to me to react as if that were so.
And that's how they justified unjustifiable deeds.
Exactly. Taking my age into account and by pretending I had a screw loose, I realized that I could continue investigating or take a look at certain places in the monastery without arousing suspicion.
You fooled me completely. And that's not an easy thing to do.
When I was younger, I was very fond of the theater. That was before my ordination.
You're a great actor. My friend Lope would be delighted with you.
Do you mean the playwright?
Do you know him?
I'm a great admirer of his. I've read several of his works in the library. He's a talented young man, though I've heard that he's in a situation which is, very similar to yours?
My exile is voluntary, but it's a known fact that he was banished for 8 years upon pain of death if he returns.
Watch your step with Nazario, dear Leonardo. Day by day, power and gold are turning the world into a much darker place.
Were you able to find out anything new in relation to witchcraft in the course of your investigations?
You must keep an eye on Martin,
the cook.
Do you know another one? A few years ago, I discovered that in reality, he's a sorcerer.
I don't understand you.
A young servant who was standing fairly close to me, but must have thought I'm deaf, told another servant that the monk in charge of the kitchen told his fortune using a deck of tarot cards that had demonic symbols on the cards.
I'm not so sure about that. Do you have proof?
I saw the deck. I know he has that deck of cards. One day, I went into the kitchen, played the mad monk, and saw it. He's a sorcerer.
I don't believe it, but I'll definitely look into it. Thank you very much for the information, Brother Arcadio. Your secret is safe with me.
And?
Well, you know Arcadio. He's a senile old man. Very little of what he says makes any sense.
Ah, right.
Hello, Martin.
Goodness, you scared me half to death.
Aren't you cooking today?
No, I suppose not. I have to go, brother.
Aren't you cooking today?
I must relieve Brother Egidio in the refectory, just like yesterday.
I'd like to ask you a few questions.
I'm sorry, I have no time at all.
I thought that life at the Abbey was relaxed enough to be able to do without chaos and stress.
It would be if three brothers hadn't died in 1 week. And above all, if the Holy Inquisition itself weren't waiting at the door. If you'll allow me, brother, you know where you can find me.
Candle wax is melting now. We'll wait a moment. A wick from inside a candle.